video, we look at the thread dial. We look at the difference between a metric thread dial and an imperial thread dial. We also look at how we can make one using a 3D printer. So let's go into the workshop and see how we do it.
So if you have a 3D printer or you know somebody who has, the first thing you need to do is download the program from the website. So we type in thingiverse.com and in the search box we type in South Bend thread dial. Then it should come up with the thread dial, and I notice on the right it has a printed nut for the screw on the top slide. Select the thread dial and it'll come up with some more information on the parts, the settings and the program. But this program prints the body in two halves. But if you look lower down in the program details, the part highlighted in blue is another thread dial which has a one part body, and that's what you need to select for the thread dial that I'm using.
This is the printout. This is for a South Bend lathe imperial with a lead screw 8 teeth per inch. It will fit the Boxford imperial lathe because the Boxford was based on the South Bend, and this is what it looks like. When you've downloaded it from the computer to your printer and printed it out, it looks something like this.
These are supports to hold
the parts in position while they're being printed. So now I can break all these off, clean it all up, and we're back to just a normal printout which is ready to go. All you need to do is drill a hole out on the side, fit a metal bar to fit your Boxford, drill a hole through for the spindle, fit this on the top of the spindle and this on the bottom of the spindle, and it's virtually ready to go. The top wheel has already got the numbers printed on it and the divisions. The gear ready to go. So first of all, I'll clean this down and we'll come back to it when I've cleaned all the
supports off it.
So once you've cleaned it up, it should look something like this. On the dial, all I've done is put some felt tip pen into the grooves and sanded the top down to give you the numbers. Haven't done anything to the gear, just taken the bits of flash off that occur. And on this, I've taken the flash off. That's ready for drilling. So what we have to do on this is
ream through here 3/8 of an inch
to support a rod to hold it onto your saddle, and then make a spindle that goes through that holds the gear on the bottom and the dial on the top. Now I know this is for an imperial lathe and mine's metric. So what do you have to do to assemble this?
I'm using an 8mm shaft, so
put an 8mm reamer through the hole to make sure it's the right size. I did find out that the day afterwards the plastic had tightened up again and the hole was tight, and all I'm using is a brass rod that's 8mm that goes through the centre of the plastic. It should turn. It doesn't need any bushes or anything like that because it's only going slow, and there's no pressure on it. You have a hole on this side here which I tapped 5 millimeters, but what I should have done was just drilled it clearance for 5 millimeters and drill a hole in the metal bar that goes in and tap the bar, because the plastic here, I don't know if you can see, has started to split along the seams. So if you put a 5 millimeter cap head in there, if you put the thread in the bar, you're just compressing the plastic, but with the thread in the plastic, it's trying to grip the plastic. Depends what plastic you use when you do the 3D printout. I don't know what plastic this was, as my brother printed it out for me with the gears that go with it. And you need to get yourself, or make yourself, a 3/8 piece of steel, and that fits into this hole on the end. I drilled this out 3/8. It's nearly there, but it depends on the plastic you're using. You could put that in, and then with the screw that goes through here, you lock that. This part fits into the apron. The hole's already there, and this is the same with your metric lathe or imperial lathe. It's 3/8. So then on the gear, put the shaft through the centre. The gear goes on, fix the gear through there. And then on the top, same again, 8 millimeter reamer through the hole. And on here, the hole's already there. I would again drill the brass rod, tap the rod, and just put a grub screw in there. And when I assembled this one, I just dropped a little washer inside there so that the two faces are not, the two plastic faces are not rubbing. There's a spacer there. Now you need to put the grub screw through on the shaft first, so if you put this on your shaft first, measure the depth that you need, put the grub screw in to hold that, then you could put the washer on the end, feed this through. Fit this on and put the grub screw in there to hold that. I would say if you've already got the bar's size, so if you already have an 8mm bar and a 3/8 bar, it would probably take you
around an hour to finish this off. Once you've taken off all the supports and the printing takes about 3 hours, and that will depend upon the printer settings and speeds and feeds you have when you print the part.
Drill and tap three holes, put two grub screws in this part, cap it in there, and it's finished. So on the saddle, it's this hole we use for the thread dial. On the front you have a grub screw, and this is a 3/8 hole. Now if you haven't used it before, you may need to put a reamer or clean out the dirt and paint from the hole, and you should find a 3/8 rod would fit in the hole. Now the thread dial will fit in this hole. I've left the brass bar that's going through the middle full length at the moment. You can see the little pivot on the rod, but that is the finished thread dial. So I'll show you how this works. Just pull it across like that to engage it in the lead screw and push it forward to disengage it. You have to bear in mind that this is a metric lead screw and this thread dial is an imperial.
So every turn is half a tooth out on the lead screw.
When you engage the thread dial, you can actually tighten the grub screw up here to lock it. This cap head just locks the 3/8 rod to the plastic.
Cutting a thread, once you've engaged the dial, you keep it engaged until you finish cutting the thread. Now for the Boxford metric lathe, there are two main differences. One is the dial looks like this. And the other differences are it had two gears, one with a 20 tooth and one with a 21 tooth. If you look on the internet, you can find the Boxford chart that tells you which gear to use for the pitch that you're cutting. So the chart shows you the thread pitch on the left, the gear you should use, one or two, and then the position you can start cutting the thread. All of them are in A, and then you have the option of B, C, D or E. Oh well, that's it for today. I hope that was interesting. Hope you enjoyed it. Look after yourself, and we'll see you next time on enots Engineering.